Hey, my name's Dr. Carl Speer. Just finished a lecture here at SECO with my good friend, Dr. Blair Lonsberry. Our topic up here was therapeutic treatment of the anterior segment. One of the big topics that we got into was debridement of the cornea. I personally think that debridement of the cornea is a very good treatment for several anterior segment diseases. When a patient comes in either with a corneal abrasion, a patient that comes in who has a foreign body that's maybe been in the eye, now we've got some edematous cornea. One of the big treatment indications I see are patients that have herpes simplex keratitis. And where sometimes people will ask me, say, well, what's your thought process on doing debridement on a patient with herpes simplex keratitis? And quite simply, when you have herpes simplex keratitis, you have a live viral particle replicating on the cornea. The longer that viral replication occurs, it's also setting up that autoimmune response for later on to have a stromal episode. So from a treatment standpoint, at least in my mind clinically, what I like to do is take a Camara spatula or even a Wexel sponge and do what I would call, or what we typically hear called as minimal debridement or debridement, where essentially I'll use the side of that spatula, scrape that replicating virus off prior to initiating therapy, either with an oral antiviral or a topical, or in some cases, both antiviral. By debriding and having an epithelial defect, it's also been shown that you actually get more absorption and therefore more therapeutic benefit of either the oral or the topical medication in those cases. I'd encourage you to go to a workshop or another presentation, learn more about debridement, try it for yourself in your own clinic.